Today we are comparing the A6300 to the FS5. What's up everyone? So in this episode, we will pin the A6300 to the FS5. Of course, we won't go features versus features because the FS5 is a professional video camera with a lot to offer. And even though the A6300 is an amazing camera, it's not fair to expect the same features from it. Instead, we'll put the two at their highest settings, 4K S-Log3, do all the common tests, nothing scientific, just to see where both stands in the real world. Okay, let's get started with the settings we will use for this test. For the FS5, we will be recording in XAVCLQFHD 4K at 24p and 100 meg per second. This is an 8-bit 420 codec. The picture profile will be S-Log3. Shutter speed at 1/48 of a second at ISO 3200. And at 3200 Kelvin, reason being, I was trying to set it up to a white balance that could be suited for indoor, outdoor, and at night. As for the A6300, we will be recording in XAVC-S at 24p and 100 meg per second. This is also an 8-bit 420 codec. Picture profile is the same, PP9, and the shutter speed will be at 1/50th of a second since the A6300 can't do proper 180 degree shutter. ISO and white balance at 3200 as well. Setup wise, I stacked both so we have a close match. As for the lens, we are using a Sony 16mm f2.8. Now we will go through all of the following tests. Rolling shutter, color and dynamic range, moiré, low light performance, sharpness and image detail, where we will pixel peep, and finally, we will look at some slow motion. All right, so for the rolling shutter test, I basically panned left to right in front of a fence so we could see the distortion easily. This is the FS5, and as you can see, there is a decent amount of rolling shutter here. Now to the A6300, this is pretty extreme. The A6300 is known to have bad rolling shutter, and we can see it here. If we compare both shots, we can see that the FS5 handles rolling shutter better. Another test I did was hand-holding both cameras and trying to misstep so it create bumps in the image. Here both cameras are pretty equal, the FS5 may be a little smoother, but that could be due because of its form factor and weight. For the colors and dynamic range, the S-Log3 on the FS5 captured all the details and preserved the highlights. If we bring the histogram up, we see the entire range captured. Now, if we go to the A6300, similar story here, most of the details are captured, but part of the sky is blown out. Again, we have the exact same settings here on the two cameras. The FS5 was handling the sky better than this. Also, surprisingly, this image is more red than the FS5, which was more green. I'm sure some of you already noticed that. Now, if we bring the histogram up, we can see the highlights being clipped even though we are within the legal values. From what I can gather, S-Log3 on the A6300 doesn't have the same dynamic range as the FS5. I believe that the FS5 has 14 stops and the A6300 has 11, which is still a great amount for a small camera, but don't expect it to perform the same. This will also affect your grading. In this example, I did a really quick adjustment and copied the preset to the A6300 and it didn't grade it the same. Of course, we need to account for the fact that the picture profile have two different color cast here. Here is another example of the dynamic range between the FS5 and A6300. The FS5 captured all the details in the highlight, but the A6300 has clipped information. For the moiré, we'll go over this quickly. It is almost non-existent on these cameras. I filmed here brick walls, roofing tiles, and sidings, which sometimes it would give you issue with some cameras, but both cameras gathered a lot of details and it's not a concern for both of them in my opinion. Let's have a look at low light and ISO. Here, the FS5 at 8000 ISO, the details are lost a little bit in the image. We can see a lot of noise, still usable with some work. But if we look at the A6300, it is a different story. The image is still sharp, The windows of the house at the end are still really crisp and detailed. As for the noise itself, it is a little finer. To me, it is a usable shot. Some color correction may be enough on it. At 16,000, the FS5 lost a little bit of detail in the image. The image is a little muddy, nothing is sharp, and to me this is barely usable, maybe with a lot of cleanup and denoiser, this could be used. As for the A6300, still usable at 1600, the image is sharp and manageable noise. At 25,000 ISO, the FS5 image is degraded, the noise is heavy, I don't think you can salvage this image at all. As for the A6300, the image is still detailed, the noise is similar to what the FS5 noise was at 8,000 ISO. Usable shot with a little bit of work in my opinion. Now for the pixel peeping part, let's see how sharp and detailed the image is. For the FS5 here, good details, the sharpness is great too, all the type and lettering is fine. Let's compare it to the A6300 now. To me this looks better, just the metabone embossing in the cap comes out really nice, all the letters are sharper, even the cardboard texture is really noticeable. Let's punch in here the FS5 again. Not bad, good image, you can recognize the logos, you can almost read the small type as well. As for the A6300, same thing here, sharper and more detailed image, everything is crystal clear, you can read the mouse type on that box. Here we can see next to each other how the A6300 is more detailed than the FS5. Here we have another example. If we just looked at the details in the cardboard box, we can see all the little ridges in it. For the slow motion, first, both cameras can only do 120 frames per second at 1080p. So both cameras had the same settings here as well. The FS5 here create a great image, really smooth, slow motion, no jitter or anything weird happening when brought back to 24p. For the A6300, same story here, great image, smooth footage as well, on par with the FS5. If we put them side by side, both are exactly the same. For both cameras, they are creating stunning slow motion and the image isn't degraded. Okay, here's the verdict. Both cameras are great. It is good to see a small camera offering so much with its image detail and high ISO capability. It's proven itself to be worthy of a main camera. And if you're using it as a specialty camera, you know it will hold up alongside your main camera. At the end of the day, it depends on what matters to you. All right, I hope you enjoyed this comparison video. As always, subscribe to the channel, find us on Facebook, and see you next time.